Hello and welcome to another tutorial for dbmap.net. In this video, I'm going to go over more of the features of the tool. I'm assuming you've used the tool a little by now, but if you haven't, then I recommend checking out the quick start video first. Let's look at adding our own images. We could use the image map tool with the local file option, but instead I'm going to simply drag an image into the window. You can see the calculate button flashing. This is because the image is not inserted to scale. By clicking on the button, we get the calculate scale option. Click on start measurement and click 2 points to measure a known distance in the image. Enter the target length and click apply to use this calculation. Now if we lock the image and measure again by click and dragging the mouse, you can see the image is scaled correctly. We can also manually resize with the object handles. The left handle with the square will adjust the size. The other end with the circle will adjust the rotation angle. Hold the shift key to constrain the angle. You can move the center point for this handle for scaling or rotating from any location. When you add your own image, the file is not saved anywhere. If you reload or send the URL to another person, the image will be lost and needs to be loaded again manually. Subscribers can choose to upload their image to their user account, meaning the model can be shared with the image intact. This image appears under the Online Image tab, and when selected from here, the image will be loaded at the same scale as when it was uploaded. The images are merged together on the noise map, so we can use this to our advantage. We can change the merge settings. We can also change the display order of the images. You can customize the color scheme for your model, either using the button in the sidebar or by right-clicking the legend. You can select from the drop-down list of existing schemes. You can edit the existing colors by clicking the color. By clicking on the decibel level, you will load the entry into the Add a Color section at the bottom. Click the green button to add or overwrite the entries above. Subscribers can save their color schemes by clicking on the blue star button. The same can be done with sound power levels. Adding a line source is similar to using the barrier tool. Click and drag for a single section, or click successively for multiple sections, and finish the line by clicking the same point again, right-clicking, or hitting the escape key. The model will divide the line source into point sources of relative sound energy in proportion to the length of the section of the line. You can see this behavior in action by using a ray receiver. The ray receiver is a useful object for inspecting exactly what is contributing to the sound level at a certain location. It will draw a dashed line from each source to the ray receiver. Broadband sources will have a single dash for each frequency band. So a reflected ray may have gaps in the dashed line to indicate that certain frequencies were not reflected. This is due to the way that a surface is determined to be reflecting or not. In the global settings, you can toggle the parameters that affect this. If you open up the edit window, you can see the rays listed in descending order. The icons represent what has affected the propagation path, such as a blue icon for a lateral path around vertical barrier edges. Check the guide to find out more. There is an object in the tool that is only used for measurement or illustration, called the accessory line. You draw it like other line objects such as a barrier. We can give it a label. We can choose to add color, and to give it a fill to mark an area. We can also use it to measure a distance. The line has markings that match the steps on the scale bar. Let's take a look at the other modes available to subscribers. First is the cross-section view. This will allow us to create a noise map along the vertical plane. When you enter the mode, the noise map tool switches to drawing the cross-section line. While this tool is active, you can click 2 points or click and drag to set the location of the cross-section. You can also adjust either end, or move the line entirely. You can reverse the direction by clicking on the line. Adjust the size of the noise map by dragging the ends of the pop-up window. The cross-section height is modified by dragging the top edge. We can also set the cross-section line to match the face of a building or barrier. Hover over the objects and click one of the sections. The map height will also change to fit the height of the object. You can also click Rays Drawn by Array Receiver, and also click sections of an accessory line. Barriers and line sources that intersect with the cross-section line will appear on the noise map. However, only sources and receivers within 1 meter distance of the line will be included. You can choose to show the height of the horizontal noise map. You can also click the eye icon to project all your objects onto the cross-section plane. In the window, you can use the mouse to view your location along the line and measure distances. The next mode is where we can adjust the ground level. When we switch to this mode, the noise map changes to show ground level and the Add Objects toolbar switches to show our ground level objects. We have ground height points and lines. Let's draw in a few points and a line to create a slope. The ground level is triangulated from these points. We can see the ground level change by checking the colours, clicking around to see the level at a location, or we can draw on the triangulation from the checkbox in the sidebar. The highlighted lines illustrate where the ground forms a peak, which is considered as a barrier if it breaks the sound path. But the best way to see the ground level is in our last mode, the 3D view. This mode brings up a pop-up window of our model in 3D. 3D space can be a bit tricky to navigate around, so we have a few methods available to us. You can click and drag the window to rotate the screen. This rotates around the center point that is shown in the main window. We can move this around to the location we want to focus on. You can see all your objects in the rays in full 3D. We can also zoom in and out with the mouse wheel. We can move up and down the Z-axis using the arrows in the top right corner, or fix the Z-axis to match the noise map height. As we rotate the screen, you can see the compass in the bottom left move around. We can click this to reset our view. Or we can click the bottom right cubes to set the camera angle as illustrated. In the toolbar, we have icons to add the noise map and cross-section. One issue we have to be careful of when dealing with uneven ground is how our barriers and buildings are modelled. When we give a barrier a height and the barrier is configured to be flat but the ground is sloping, only one end of the barrier will be the height specified. We call this end the height reference point. We can easily flip this point by switching back to the ground level mode, hovering over the object and clicking the center point. This is only necessary with barriers that are flat, because we can choose to set the barrier to slope with the ground. Buildings can have any corner as the height reference point. Click the center point to cycle through each corner until the height reference point is where you want it. You might need to rotate the roof after doing this. If there's a certain viewpoint that you want to save, you can click this little bookmark below the scale toolbar. This will add a numbered bookmark which you can click on. You can also remove this bookmark by clicking the bookmark icon again. Let's look at how to generate a report from our model. Under the Export Import options, you'll find Export Report. This brings up the following options. We have a front cover. We can include our noise map as it appears on the screen. If you're in the cross-section mode, then the report will include the vertical noise map. If you're looking at the 3D view, then the report will include the current 3D viewpoint and the noise maps that are enabled. Our other options are to include an overview of the entire model. Then you can include the calculations and other information about the receivers in the model, starting with tables of all the receiver data, followed by small images of each receiver for visual reference, followed by charts of the receiver data. You can see a preview of the chart for deciding upon the perfect chart design. When there are multiple heights available, you can choose to group the data either by receiver, showing one receiver per chart, or by height so you can see all the receivers at a height on a single chart. The receiver detail checkbox adds a page for each receiver and includes a breakdown of all the receiver's sources. That covers most of the features of the model. Subscribers can always get in touch if they're not sure about anything.